Hi and welcome to Clever Journey, a channel where we post videos about travel gear, packing tips, and other travel related topics. In this video, we'll check out the Lean Travel 3-piece compression cube set. I've done a more throughout review on our site cleverjourney.com, so make sure to check it out. And if you're new to this channel, click the subscribe button so you never have to miss out on any of our future videos. But for now, let's get right into the review. I purchased the Lean Travel compression cubes a few months ago. I noticed that a lot of our readers on our site were purchasing this exact compression cube set, so I wanted to get it for myself and check out how good they are in real life. Right now, I've been testing them for about 2 or 3 months, and so far nothing has broken and they still look in a very good condition. By the way, the Lean Travel compression cubes are one of the more popular options on Amazon because they're very cheap and they're very well reviewed. If you don't know the difference between packing cubes and compression cubes, essentially compression cubes come with 2 zippers and regular packing cubes only with 1 zipper. The first zipper is a regular one, which closes the main compartment, and the second one is the compression zipper, which compresses everything inside by several inches. In another video, I performed a test where I compared the space savings between no packing cubes, regular packing cubes, and compression cubes. I found out that packing cubes save about 5% of the total space and compression cubes about 15 to 20%. So if you're looking to save some space, compression cubes is definitely the way to go. Really, the only downside to using compression cubes is that your clothes will become more wrinkled in them because of all the compression that's going on. So if you're packing dress shirts, then you should probably stick to regular packing cubes instead. I purchased the Lean Travel 3-piece compression cube set, but they're also sold as a 6-piece set. They're available in black, brown, gray, and green pattern color options. If I'd buy them again, I'd probably choose the option where each cube is in a different color, so that it's easier to remember what you've packed in each cube. The Lean Travel 3-piece set comes with 2 large compression cubes and 1 medium compression cube. When the compression zipper is unzipped, the cubes are about 4.5 inches in depth, but when it's closed, the width is reduced to about 3 inches. In my Child Pro MaxLite 5 carry-on, I can squeeze in the 2 larger cubes. There's still some space left at the top, but it's too small for the medium cube. So I usually pack the 2 large compression cubes in my carry-on and the medium cube in my backpack, which I use as a personal item. In total, all 3 cubes weigh around 600 grams or 20 ounces. For instance, the Eagle Creek 2-piece compression cube set, which I reviewed in another video, weighs 110 grams or 4 ounces. So compared to other compression cubes, the Lean Travel cubes are very heavy. They're made from a thick polyester fabric, which feels much thicker than what I've seen on other packing organizers. In the corners, they're also reinforced with flexible wires, which makes the cubes retain their shape when they're packed full. The seams look pretty good, but I wouldn't say that it's the best stitching that I've seen. You can see a few loose threads here and there. Although the Lean Travel compression cubes are somewhat bulky, I actually think that it's not necessarily a bad thing. Compression cubes are put under a lot of force when you're compressing them, so having everything extra thick and reinforced means they'll last longer. These compression cubes come with pretty massive SBS zippers. SBS is a very durable zipper brand, similar to the Japanese YKK zippers, only they're slightly cheaper and more popular in China. What's good about them is that usually nothing gets stuck in the zipper when you're trying to close them. That's because the zippers are very massive, the fabric is very thick, and because of the reinforced corners. That's definitely a good thing because on the Eagle Creek compression cubes, the fabric gets stuck in the zippers all the time. But now, let's find out how much stuff fits inside each compression cube. I'll pack them kind of full, but not to the maximum capacity. You should pack them so full that you're able to close the compression zipper easily without too much effort. Otherwise, your clothes will become too wrinkled and you might damage the zippers or the seams. The medium cube is best used for packing all the smaller items, such as t-shirts, underwear, and socks. I managed to fit in 6 rolled-up t-shirts, 6 pairs of man's boxers, and 6 pairs of socks in there. And the 2 larger compression cubes are best used for packing all the larger items, such as pants, shirts, sweaters, jackets, and so on. In 1 large cube, I managed to fit 2 pairs of pants, 2 pairs of shorts, and 2 sweaters inside. And in the other one, I squeezed in an extra bulky winter jacket and 2 bulky sweaters. And now, here's my final verdict on the Lean Travel 3-piece compression cube set. These compression cubes are very easy to use and they're hard to break because they're very bulky and thick. Unfortunately, this means that they're also very heavy. This three-piece set weighs roughly 5 times as much as the Eagle Creek two-piece compression cube set. But in reality, this isn't a huge deal breaker because 600 grams or 20 ounces still isn't that much compared to the total weight of your suitcase. One huge advantage over the Lean Travel compression cubes is that they're very affordable. If you don't want to spend that much on compression cubes, then I'd say that the Lean Travel compression cubes is a very great choice. If you do decide to get them, check out our full review on cleverjourney.com, which I've linked out to in the description of this video. And if you're new here, we post all kinds of useful videos about traveling and travel gear. If you're interested in traveling, click the subscribe button to not miss out on any of our future videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.